I have described the developments in the broadband markets in the European Union and the main challenges that they face, meaning the migration from current internet access, the way we know it now, to very fast internet access, or what we call very high-speed broadband access technologies. This is an important chapter of the Digital Agenda for Europe, which is the main policy initiative in support of the spread of information and communication technologies in the European Union. And the European Union has agreed to very important and ambitious targets for the next decade to ensure that the migration takes place. The challenge is important because Europe at the moment risks to fall behind other important world economies because the rate of investment in this new infrastructure is currently low. And there is a risk of an important loss in terms of competitiveness that the European Union cannot afford. This is the reason why the Commission has put on the table some proposals aiming at facilitating or stimulating investment, in particular reducing investment cost, which is the main barrier to the migration to this new infrastructure. In the article, I have looked at the current situation in the European markets. I have provided an overview of developments in the various European countries, highlighting in some places the fragmentation between these countries and the different characteristics that they have. I have highlighted the important role played by the regulatory framework for electronic communications and the main initiatives undertaken by the Commission in this area, as well as those undertaken by the Member States. This is a new challenge, and at the moment there is very interesting experimentation, let's say, ongoing in different Member States and among the players and the various governments. The European Union has experienced extraordinary growth in the past decade in terms of rollout and take-up of broadband. More than 60% of households and more than 90% of enterprises nowadays do have a broadband connection. And this is also the result of a favorable regulatory environment. However, there are some weaknesses. First of all, there is fragmentation still across member states, meaning that the single market in electronic communications is not as strong as it should be or as it is in other economic sectors. Secondly, as I highlighted earlier, investment in the new infrastructure is still limited. And this is why the Digital Agenda for Europe has called for focusing the policy on the achievement of targets which are clear and which foresee universal broadband coverage by 2020 of at least 30 megabit per second and some connections with speeds higher than 100 megabit per second. To achieve these targets, the Commission has put on the table some proposals. In 2010, a Commission communication has suggested some ways to reduce investment cost and also has proposed a common framework for member states who are expected to provide national targets as well as national broadband plans. Moreover, we have put on the table a recommendation for next generation access. This is to strengthen our regulatory environment, in particular providing more clarity on the rules that govern access to this new infrastructure. And finally, a radio spectrum policy program is supposed to make even more available frequencies that can be used in electronic communications, in particular to stimulate the development of wireless broadband. Because wireless or fixed broadband, they both go hand in hand to deliver the targets that the digital agenda has set. Some of these insights will be developed further in a document called the Scoreboard of the Digital Agenda, which will be published for the first time this year on the 30th of May. So there we will be providing also more updates on the monitoring of broadband markets. So find us online on the 30th of May on the website of the Digital Agenda.